Hello everyone, my name is Ashish. I'm a student innovator and an open source contributor. So before I start off today, let me ask a question. So how many of you have heard of Google Summer of Code or open source in general? I can see a few hands, so I assume a handful of people. So let's begin off with a story. A few months back, I received an email. It was my acceptance letter to the Google Summer of Code program, an initiative by Google to promote open source. I was really excited, proud, and honestly, a little relieved. Naturally, I went online to find out how others had done. But what I found really surprised me. There was a lot of frustration, a lot of anger. Contributors who didn't make it were publicly attacking the organization and their maintainers. Some blamed the system, while others mocked those who were selected. And the online discussions that should have been about ideas, projects, and learning turned into arguments, negativity, and disappointment. A program that was designed to promote and celebrate open collaboration and started to feel like just another competition. The focus was only on who made it and who didn't. That moment made me pause and ask myself, have we forgotten what open source is really about? We, as Indian youngsters, are incredibly competitive and ambitious. But programs like GSOC and Smart India Hackathon have started to become the next JEE for aspiring engineers. Many now only see these programs as lines to add to a resume or stipends to earn from, rather than opportunities through which one can be part of an amazing community and experience the doors that open when you contribute to open source. And for many, open source simply just means free code or a shortcut to being shortlisted into some fancy program. But open source is something much bigger. It is the idea that we can build freely, share openly, and solve problems together. It doesn't mean being the smartest person in the room. It's about asking yourself, what if I share my solution so someone else doesn't have to face the same challenges that I did? And open source isn't just about software. It extends to every branch of engineering. Most of you might have heard of Arduino. Let's take that as an example. Something that used to live in expensive labs is now accessible to innovators, hobbyists, and students worldwide. A student from a small town can now build his own robot at his own pace. In fact, I myself started my robotics journey in high school the same way. Or let's consider RISC-V, an open source processor architecture. For decades, the brains of our computers were controlled by a handful of companies. But with RISC-V, universities, innovators, and even individuals can design their own processors at their own pace. And in mechanical engineering, open source 3D printers have not just made prototyping affordable, but has also sparked entire industries of makers. The principle is just the same. Share your knowledge, lower the barriers, and let people create your own solutions. But here's the problem. A lot of us treat innovation as a checklist. How many of you have seen the same projects again and again online? The same web apps, the same face detection, the same chatbots. Hundreds of versions, not because the world truly needs it, but just so that people can say, look, I can build this too. But innovation doesn't begin with, what's the coolest algorithm I can use? It begins with asking yourself, what problem can I solve that actually helps someone? In my own journey, I've been both a user and a contributor. I've made use of open source tools for my projects and have the opportunity to contribute through repos, through programs, and now recently with GSoft with JD Robo. But the main fun part was it having my name on a repo or adding a few lines to my resume. It was realizing that something I built might help a student or a user halfway across the world. And that's why open source matters. So stop approaching open source or innovation in general as a race for recognition. Because when we do, we miss the real purpose, which is to power, to accelerate solutions. Most advanced robotic systems these days are open source. The reason they evolve so quickly isn't because a single company owns it. It is because all of us can contribute to it freely. Now, you might be wondering, I don't have any big ideas. I don't have any experience with open source. Can I really contribute? Well, the answer is absolutely. Because open source isn't about being a genius coder or reinventing the wheel. It is about starting small and growing with the community. Your first step could be fixing a broken link in a documentation or translating a video so others can learn from it. It can also be sharing a tool that you built by yourself, because chances are someone else might need it too. And that's how contributions begin. Small, useful, and genuine. So, here's what I want you to leave with. You don't need to wait for a fancy program, or you don't need to be an expert. All you need is a bit of curiosity, some empathy, and a willingness to share. Even if one person leaves here thinking today, maybe I can contribute too, then we have already started the ripple effect. Because innovation isn't about imitation. It isn't about competition. It's about impact. And open source gives us the chance to create. Thank you.